guys. We are still here in Cleveland, and this time we're going to the Great Lakes Brewing Company, and that's one of those just old school classic craft breweries, one of those first places that I remember getting stuff from, or at least craft beer from. I was always disappointed that Great Lakes was Ohio and not the state of Michigan. Just made, because, you know, Great Lakes State. But anyways, just up here, and let's check it out. All right, guys, got the first flight. It was of the classic beers here. Yeah, check this out, this is cool. They actually have, like, the pictures, the labels, which I thought was kind of cool. Of course, I wish they had, like, the ABV and stuff like that on it, but most things. Alright, let's go with the Dortmunder Gold Lager first. It's kind of like lager meets an amber ale. Bit of a grainy maltiness. Yeah, it really is like a nice lager with just a bit of that amber ale aspect to it. A little bit of maltiness, not really bitter at all. Nice combo. I'll tell you what, one thing I don't like about these, I've used like an app to order. You can't ask for water or anything like that. It's kind of annoying. Next we have the Elliott Ness Amber. Less malty than the lager. Almost a dab of the vanilla aspect to it. Kind of creamy. Again, not very bitter or at all bitter. Very subtle maltiness. I feel like the amber lager is easier to drink than the gold lager. But I like it. Now we got the crush-worthy low-cal citrus.
Hey there.
Hello.
Those sticks.
Awesome, thank you. Okay, great. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Not sure how hot the... Yeah, you should be all right.
All right, great. Thank you. Again, one thing I don't like about the ordering on the app is you order an appetizer and a dish, and they both come out at the same time. So, that one thing's going to get cold. Let's finish this up. Yeah, this is a low-cal citrus wheat. You blow through this. I wish I'd actually say what the calorie was. Yeah, you could just shred this. Kind of has more of that traditional New England style. A bit of a piney taste to it. It's almost refreshing to get just a more traditional IPA. versus some of the newer stuff. It's like, it tastes older. Like, this has been around a while. Has a bit. This, I don't know, I think this is a very enjoyable IPA. It's not like nothing crazy. It's just like a classic before IPAs exploded. So I feel like the bitterness level is just perfect. Now we have the Commodore Perry IPA. Sounds more like a British IPA. Commodore Perry. Got that very definitely tastes like a British ale, which more of like that malty bitterness versus a piney. It's almost got a dab of that Oktoberfest Marzen meets British IPA. I can dig it. My last one is the classic Edmund Fitzgerald Porter. It's got that dark chocolate smokiness to it. Kind of barrel. It's got like a barrel age, but it's not like heavy. Doesn't have that the liquor barrel age. It just has kind of that barrel wood taste. Bit of a black molasses. Not black molasses. Black licorice. But yeah, classic. Excellent one. I mean, I got the classic flights. You couldn't really go wrong with them. I thought that's how I started out. But yeah, all six. Very good. If I had to rank them, I'd say 6 is the Commodore Perry, 5 is the Dortmunder Gold Lager. Four is the Crushworthy Locale Citrus. It's got kind of a line in Kugel, some shandy thing going on. Three, I'm saying, is the Elliott Ness Amber Lager, another classic. Two, I'm going to do the Edmund Fitzgerald Porter. And number one, Great Lakes IPA. I feel like this is a fantastically perfect IPA for me. That's those six. Well, pun. Okay, and also 6 flights, 5-ounce pours each. Only $15. That's not bad. So, but yeah. Anyways, let me get into this food. All right, guys, we're just leaving the Great Lakes Brewing Company, and honestly, I would have gotten another flight, but the problem with the QR code ordering, at least the method that I've found in Cleveland, is these servers are just like poof, vanished. They're not around. And so you can't really talk to them or ask them questions or do anything like that. They basically don't exist except to bring out whatever you ordered, and then they just poof, they disappear, they're gone. And so it makes it tricky. I don't like that they haven't, that they, you know, this is almost July, and they didn't figure out that when you're ordering an appetizer and a meal, you probably want the appetizer to come out first, because then it prevents you eating the regular meal cold. But every time I've ordered an appetizer and a meal in Cleveland, everything's come out at the same time, and then that just kind of throws off how you're eating it. Something's gonna get cold because something else is sitting there. So I don't know why they had struggle with figuring that out, but I guess I can't. I mean, it's a COVID thing, but still, it's one of those things where you're like, you guys should be able to figure this out. Like, it's pretty, like, you guys do appetizers, so it gives your kid the kitchen time to make the regular course. That's part of the reason why it exists, and to make more money. But so that the fact that that's a struggle in Cleveland. But then it does take 100,000 Buckeyes to help sound out the word Ohio. So maybe figuring out how to bring the appetizer out first makes sense. Maybe if they had 100,000 people yelling, appetizer first, they'd figure it out. But it's not that thing. Anyways, the beers are all good. I liked all six. Again, I would have gotten another flight, but because of the QR code thing, it made it too much of a pain in the ass. And so, didn't do that. Check out the pretzel review. As for the meal I got fish and chips. Gotta admit, disappointed in the fish and chips. For a place that's called Great Lakes Brewing Company, it should be better. But usually when I get fish and chips, I will order the... I'll try the fish before I dump it into the tartar sauce. And this one just had zero flavor. Just no flavor at all. It was fried fish, and it was just nothing. Disappointing. And even the fries. The fries were kind of had this... onion consistency, where it was battered and everything, and I like the batter, but they were soggy, they were limp, and that usually happens because the potatoes are still starchy, and to do that, to get rid of the starch, you have to pre-soak the potatoes. You soak the potatoes, you get the starch out, so then when you bake them, they're nice and crispy. So it's like they attempted to batter the fries to make up for the fact that they were too lazy to, soak the potatoes. Just like, dude, just pre-soak the potatoes. You'll get a much better fry. So the fish and chips was kind of like, ooh. But, you know, whatever. You go for the beer. I mean, the food was fine. It could have been better with a few minor tweaks. It could be a lot better. But it's one of those things. But definitely better than the saucy place. That place, garbage. Garbage, garbage, garbage. But, yeah, that's really it. I just, again, I would have done another flight. Maybe if I'm ever in Cleveland again and it's not a pandemic and they've figured out how to do regular stuff. You know, they figured out how to bring your appetizer at a normal time and all that stuff. But for the most part, Great Lakes Brewing Company was good. The beers I had were great. I got the classic stuff. Again, I wanted to get something away from the classics to try those out. But just one of those things. I would say COVID, but you know, it's almost July, so you shouldn't really have those kinds of extreme issues anymore. But it's one of those things. So yeah, that is the last brewery review I'll be doing in Cleveland. And I'm not sure what the next one will be. But anyways, check out the pretzel review, and I will catch you guys later.